Good day, everyone, and welcome back to The Teacher, your go-to channel for insightful tutorials. I'm your host, and today we have an exciting tutorial lined up. We'll be delving into techniques to elevate the presentation of static pictures, making them more engaging for your audience. If you haven't already, do check out our previous tutorial on animating in PowerPoint using GIF and PNG files for additional information and expert tricks. Before we dive in, you can find the download link for today's presentation in the video description or in the cards above. This resource is available free of charge on our website, and if you'd like to support us further, exclusive access to all our presentations is also available on our Patreon page. The animation we'll explore today draws inspiration from the incredible work of Wakana Y.K. on CodePen.io. While Wakana used HTML, CSS, and JS, we've challenged ourselves to replicate similar animation effects using only PowerPoint. The link to Wakana's original work is provided in the video description. If you're interested in experimenting with the same pictures, source codes are conveniently linked for your use. After downloading and opening the presentation, let's begin by opening the selection and animation panes side by side. This allows us to comprehensively view all available objects and their corresponding animation effects on the current slide. In PowerPoint, every single or grouped object can be considered a layer. To grasp the presentation's design and animation effects, start by hiding all objects or layers. Then, systematically reveal one layer at a time while observing the animation pane. This approach provides a clear understanding of the applied animation effects for each object. Now, let's take a closer look at the components. The first object is an audio file used for background music. You can access a vast collection of royalty-free music from the audio library of YouTube Studio. By default, downloaded audio files are typically saved in the Downloads folder if you're using Google Chrome. To incorporate the audio, go to the Insert tab and use the Audio on My PC command. If your presentation includes an audio file, ensure you select the file either from the selection pane or by clicking on the audio icon on the slide. Two new tabs, namely Audio Format and Playback, will appear in the Office ribbon. From the Playback tab, make note of the applied audio playback settings. In this presentation, we're starting the audio automatically during the slideshow. A pro tip, if you plan to use audio in your presentation, insert and configure the audio file settings beforehand, whether you're using one or multiple audio files. Now that we have our audio settings in place, the next crucial step is to carefully position the audio file within the animation pane. I recommend always inserting and placing the audio file on top of the selection and animation panes. This ensures easy configuration of start timings as needed for a seamless presentation. To maintain a polished appearance, the audio file icon should be positioned outside the slide area. Alternatively, you can utilize the Hide During Show option from the Playback tab to prevent the audio file icon from appearing during the slideshow. Moving on, we have a text shape in the selection pane strategically placed above the five pictures on the slide. This positioning ensures that the text overlays all the pictures, providing clarity and visual hierarchy. The focal point of our presentation is the static picture, showcasing a stunning living room with a large picture frame hanging on the wall. The goal is to animate the picture frame, displaying four different pictures with captivating animation effects, creating the illusion of a digital picture frame. Let's focus on picture one. In the animation pane, you'll notice two applied animations, a diagonal motion path and a fade exit effect. Hovering over the animation effect bar reveals the start and end timings. Alternatively, you can find these details in the Animations tab under Start, Duration, and Delay Timings. The motion path effect begins with previous, lasting for 3 seconds, with no delay. The green and red dots in the motion path represent the starting and ending points, respectively. Additionally, an auto reverse is applied, causing the picture to move from start to end and then reverse back. The second animation effect on picture 1 is the fade exit effect, set to occur with previous, but with a 3.50-second delay. This results in picture 1 fading out while reversing back to its original location. The fade-out effect's duration is 2.50 seconds, ensuring both motion path and fade effects conclude simultaneously. Extending these principles to pictures 2, 3, and 4, you'll notice similar animation effects, motion path, and fade exit. The key distinction lies in their delay timings. For instance, picture 2 starts its diagonal motion at 3.50 seconds precisely when picture 1 begins fading out. This sequential arrangement continues, with picture 3 initiating at 7.00 seconds and picture 4 following suit. This meticulous sequence of animation effects crafts a visually appealing picture embedding effect during the slideshow. As we conclude, let's take a closer look at the layer positioning in the selection pane. Notice that the static picture layer is strategically placed atop pictures 1 to 4 layers. The static subtracted picture layer, with the picture frame areas subtracted, allows us to peer through, showcasing the background. This clever arrangement creates the illusion of a living room with a digital picture frame hanging on the wall, adding depth and realism to our presentation. Before we wrap up this lesson, I want to quickly demonstrate how you can subtract a portion of a picture using the Merge Shapes command. Follow along as I insert a new slide into our presentation. Here, I'll insert the original static picture of a living room with a picture frame hanging on the wall. The goal is to subtract the picture frame area to display our animated pictures in the background. Using a frame-sized rectangle, I'll carefully select the picture first, then holding down the Shift key, select the rectangle. Navigating to the Shape Format tab, I'll click the Merge Shapes drop-down menu and choose the Subtract command. This simple yet powerful technique enables us to create dynamic presentations with layered visuals. Now, let's recap the process of animating the pictures. After subtracting the picture frame, insert the first picture you want to animate. Adjust its size and position. Head to the Animations tab, click on Add Animation, select More Motion Paths, and apply a diagonal upright motion path. Customize the start and end positions of the motion path to suit your preferences, and fine-tune the start, duration, and delay timings. Don't forget to use the Auto Reverse feature for added flair. Repeat this process for subsequent pictures, applying motion path and fade out effects with carefully calibrated durations and delays. Adjust the layer positions either by dragging and dropping in the selection pane or using the send to back command from the format tab. I trust you found this tutorial both useful and enlightening. If you've picked up a new skill or have any thoughts, share them in the comments below. Remember to like and subscribe to stay updated on more insightful tutorials. Until next time, take care, and I look forward to seeing you in my next video.